speech is really the worst. It should be abolished and put in a vacuum-packed rocket ship on a one-way ticket to outer space so we never have to hear or see it again. No one should have hurt feelings, and no one should ever be disrespected, because disrespect is bad and hurtful, and it is the basis for hate. But what is hate speech, and who defines it? For conservative rabble-rousers like Alex Jones, it's the bully nexus of modern social media who feel obligated morally to soften the edges of mean words. The great lathe of digital groupthink has oppressed the popular button pusher who has the habit of saying god-awful things just to get attention, as YouTube, Apple, Facebook, and Spotify are doing their best to scrub the ether of Jones' unholy sins. Now, it seems like we're in a left-right scalp-gathering match where both sides are going tit-for-tat to ruin people's lives. I have no doubt Roseanne, Sarah Jong, James Gunn, and James Woods, to name a few, have all said really stupid, hurtful, idiotic, messed-up word turds that collectively add up to a ferocious and putrid dung pile of impulsive nonsense. But should they all be banned and banished from social media? No! Do you really want elitist, new money leftists determining your taste? Does attribute-free, saccharine-steeped content sound at all inviting? Aw, hell no. In fact, that stirs up new levels of rage. Or dare I say, hate. As Twitter suspends the accounts of Daniel McAdams, Scott Horton, and Peter Van Buren, they are not safeguarding the world from toxic, predatory evildoers. They're attempting to control thought, conversation, and ultimately society by whitewashing sharp minds who dare penetrate the well-crafted bubbles of people who've mistakenly bought into the notion that it's somehow better to be intellectually safe than challenged, and that the world can only tolerate one safe lane of expression. Words are not deeds, but oppression and social engineering by force are the dirtiest deeds of all. And that's the memo.